Okay, take the variation or two if you like, or just stay in the pose for a little bit. For that, don't rush if you feel in the middle of something. Finish up and then come down and rest if you feel. We'll take supta virasana. Use whatever height you need, but if you don't need a height, feel free to lie flat or back, whatever you need. Told you about the, it's a Tibetan word.
Emaho.
E-M-A-H-O.
Yeah. Means
it basically A-A-H-O. Often some texts start with that exclamation. Emaho, listen carefully, my heart children. Things like that. Really nice. Emaho basically means how amazing, how marvelous. In the home. So we've been pretty active so far. You see, gradually the breath settling, resting on your support, if your eye support, releasing the back muscles off the spine gradually, but allowing the breath to settle in its own time. Be present without manipulating the breath. Very relaxed eardrums, as if they were descending linear. Very relaxed eyeballs, shrinking, sitting back in the sockets, the mind of the eyes, retreating to the back of the brain. A deep release in the throat center, the vocal cords. in the shape of the pose, raise the structural mobility, stability, the physiological benefit to the organ systems. And as you rest, when you integrate the breathing, you're beginning to experience the subtle body, the breath, knowing the body as a field of energy, humming, that's arising in the skylight space of your mind. You tend to solidify these physical sensations, but it's nothing, it's actually the constant fluctuation and flow of prana and consciousness. You don't lose sight of the basic anatomical skill, and yet the more you can drop deeper, deeper down into the breath, the nerves, the relaxation of the eyes and eardrums, the vocal cords, beginning to touch the energy body, the chronic teeth, the sun body, the sutra chimera. The body is not as solid as the dense exterior. Imagine sitting up out of your seat like you're outside. Then the Emma Ho, how amazing is that a thought, right, a non-physical flow of energy in our brain cells can move this corporeal thing we call our bodies. That is Emma Ho. It's amazing. Or as we used to say, far out. John Denver invitation. Far out. Okay, sarvangasana. But just remember what George Harrison said in one of his songs. It's so far out, the way out is in. Life flows on within you and without you.
Right.
So, nice sarvangasana. Not sure what your relationship is to this pose today. Joyful curiosity. Or, okay, I'll do it, but I won't like it. Maybe somewhere in between. Shoulder stand's one of those poses I used to really struggle with. It was always hard for me to do it. And of course I did it. and nowadays, it takes me a couple of minutes just to feel like I'm getting into the pose.
Right.
So I never trust my first emotional response to it.
It's like a pancake.
In what way, Tracy?
Well, you never trust the first pancake.
That's right. It's never quite right, is it?
Or the latke, the first one. It's not quite right.
Or the first macaroon, I don't know. Okay. The nice thing is most of you are longtime practitioners. I wouldn't want to say senior students. You might think I'm calling you old. But so your body has an intuition. It has a cellular memory, a muscular memory in this posture. And that will tend to kick in before your conceptual mind even starts to, quote, do the pose. As you receive that memory of the pose, then today's posture is becoming known. Then you can do the pose. And occasionally, the pose will do you. You go from doing sarvangasana to being sarvangasana. But that's something that won't work if you look for it. And then take Halasana. Interlock your fingers and extend your arms. Tuck the outer triceps, deltoids under. Keep grounding the root of the arm without squeezing the collarbone. Open the collarbones to ground the head of the humerus so the throat is free. With the inner side armpit chest ribs up. You don't feel like the armpit chest ribs are pushing down, they're ascending from the arm. Then take the legs wide apart and seek the colostomy. Then take the arms over the head. With the palms up, and if possible, take a hold of your outer edges of your feet. Release the arms. If you need to bring the arms behind you, you'll roll out the pose. Do that. Otherwise, roll down with the arms over the head. Tuck the chin. And then set up a nice supported setubandha. Thank you. And shavasana. Shavasana. refresh your awareness. Recognize basic realities and harmony of life in the millions of years.